we have state news, that is Andhra Pradesh government has revived the zero interest loan scheme for women self-help groups. So this was first given by zero interest loan scheme for SHGs by Kiran Kumar. So let us see in detail about this zero interest scheme. So Andhra Pradesh government have revived this zero interest loan scheme for women self-help groups, SHGs, in the state. So CM YS Jagan Mohan Reddy has relaunched the scheme by releasing a sum of 1400 crore rupees for the self-help groups. So recently Madhya Pradesh have also launched the insurance cover for COVID-19 for Anganwadi workers. Now Andhra Pradesh government have revived this zero interest loan scheme for women self-help groups. So in the state. So this was first launched by Chief Minister N. Kiran Kumar Reddy, which is when it is a united AP, that is both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana were united at that time. So this was launched by Kiran Kumar Reddy first, and then the scheme was again revived by at present CM Jagan Mohan Reddy, which is a zero interest loan scheme, that means the interest will be zero. So the amount has also been released, 1400 crore has been released for the self-help groups. So the decision is expected to benefit over 8.78 lakh self-help groups in the state, involving over 93.80 lakh women. So under this scheme, each self-help group will receive some ranging from 20,000 rupees to 40,000 rupees towards the interest component on their loan. So as they have zero interest, and the sum will be given from 20,000 to 40,000 depending upon the interest components on their loans. So the zero interest scheme was launched by APCM Jagan Mohan Reddy. So remember, when coming to state news, this will be important. Zero interest scheme for the self-help SHGs, self-help groups, is by CM Jagan Mohan Reddy, APCM Jagan Mohan Reddy. Okay, and it was first launched by CM N. Kiran Kumar Reddy. It is also important. Yes, now let us move on to the next topic. Country's foreign exchange reserves have increased over $3 billion. Now let us see why. So here, the country's foreign exchange reserves have been increased to $3.9 billion to $479.57 billion in the week of April 17 due to an increase in foreign currency assets. So due to the lockdown economic crisis, we have the foreign exchange reserves have been increased. So from the latest data by RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, we have that during the weekend, that is from April 17th, these foreign currency assets, FCA, have a major component of overall reserves, which have increased from US$1.55 billion to $441.88 billion. So this is about the data which was given by RBI. RBI has also showed the data about the gold reserves, which have increased so from 1.54 billion to 32.68 billion in the reporting week, that is in the end of April 17th. So this is the current foreign exchange reserves, which have surged by 3.9 billion to 479.57 billion, and gold reserves from 1.54 billion to 32.68 billion. So yes, this is about the report given by RBI. Now, when we see coming to the business category, we have Vodafone and Idea. So Vodafone Idea is same now, which has tied up with the Paytm to launch this Recharge Sathi. So the name of it is Recharge Sathi. Vodafone India and Paytm have tied up. So this is a Recharge Sathi program. These are digital payments and financial services platform have launched this Recharge Sathi program, which helps each individual and small businesses to earn an additional income. So earlier, when we do not have more internet access, we used to go to the small vendors, shops, milk booths, and the paper selling and small vendor business. So where you used to buy recharge coupons, right? So this at present, this is not the same scenario. Now here, Recharge Sathi program is the same, where individuals and small business persons such as pharmacies, milk booth operators, newspaper vendors, and individuals would able to earn up to rupees 5,000 every month under this program. Now let us see what is this Recharge Sathi program. So this program will enable any Paytm customers following a registration. You need to follow a registration process in order to start selling these recharge coupons of Vodafone and Idea on Paytm app. So you need to sell these on Paytm app. So they can start selling these mobile recharges by downloading and registering on the Paytm app. So Vodafone and India will give an assured cashback to the merchant partners for multiple recharges. So up to 5,000 will be earned by the all these vendors for selling the recharge coupons of Vodafone and Idea. So in order to sell it, you need to first of all register in Paytm. So this is about the business deal between Vodafone Idea and Paytm, that is Recharge Sathi program. So when we come to appointments, we have Sanjay Kothari, who has took oath as the Chief Vigilance Commissioner. So recently Sanjay Kothari has removed from the office of Secretary to President, because Kapil Dev Tripathi has been nominated as the Secretary to the President of India, that is Ramnath Kovind. Now Sanjay Kothari has took oath as the Chief Vigilance Commissioner. So when we see in detail, so earlier he used to work as the Secretary to our President of India, Ramnath Kovind. So now he has been appointed as the Chief Vigilance Commissioner. So he is a IAS officer. Now this oath was took in Rashtrapati Bhavan. So they have followed all the social distancing norms, which you can see here. So, and the oath was given by in the presence of President Ramnath Kovind. So Mr. Kothari was reportedly shortlisted as the Central Vigilance Commissioner in the February this year by high powered panel headed by the Prime Minister. So this appointment committee will be giving appointments. Now Sanjay Kothari has been shortlisted as the Central Vigilance Commissioner, and now he had took the oath as Central Vigilance Commissioner. Now let us see what is the Central Vigilance Commission is about, that is CVC. So now the present Secretary to the President of India is Kapil Dev Tripathi. We have discussed in the earlier sessions too. So coming to the Central Vigilance Commission, it is an anti-corruption watchdog with autonomous status. Now it has got the autonomous status in the year 2003. So earlier it was an Indian government body which was established in the year 1964. So in the year 1964, it has been established. So earlier that was an apex Indian government body, but from the year 2003, it has become autonomous. So here, so this parliament enacted a law conferring statutory status to the Central Vigilance Commission in the year 2003. Then it has become the autonomous body. So coming to autonomous body, then it is free of control from any executive authority. No upper higher authorities will be there. And it can be charged with monitoring all vigilance activity under the central government of India, advising various authorities in central government organizations in planning, executing, reviewing and reforming their vigilance work. So coming to the formation, so in the year 1964, Central Vigilance Commission have been formed and the headquarters is in New Delhi. And now at present, the commissioner is Central Vigilance Commissioner is IAS Sanjay Kothari. Now coming to the sports category, we have FIH Pro League Season 2 has been extended by 1 year due to the COVID-19. So that is International Hockey Federation, FIH, have announced the second edition of FIH Hockey Pro League to be extended to the June 2021 due to the ongoing pandemic of COVID-19. And this second edition of Pro League will initially set up to run from January to June 2020. Around one third of the planned matches were completed between January and early March. So after this March, the pandemic started showing its effect. So now the second edition has been postponed. So India at present is fourth on the table with 10 points from 2 wins and as many number of losses and draws behind Belgium, Australia and Netherlands. So first one is Belgium, second is Australia, third is Netherlands and fourth place we have India. So the national game of India is not hockey. It is just a default game of India, that is hockey. Okay. Now let us move on to the next topic. We have obituary. Former Australian cricketer Graham Watson have died at the age of 75. So he has died due to cancer. So he is a primarily a middle order batsman and medium pace bowler who have featured in nearly 5 tests from 1961 to 1972 and 2 ODIs in 1972. So he's also an all-rounder who have earned the national call during the 1966 to 67 tour of Rhodesia and South Africa. It is also said that he used to also play football in Melbourne, Australia. So yes, this is about the Graham Watson, who had died while fighting the cancer at the age of 75. So this is all about the April 26th current affairs. So yes, please do share, as well as if you like my video, please press the like button and hit the bell icon for the upcoming notification, and do share as much as I can, and please do share in the social media platforms also. Let us meet tomorrow at 10 a.m. Thank you for watching my session.